I'm Christopher Lewis.
And I'm Linda Lewis. And this week on Side by Side, we're visiting Sedona, Arizona. It's about 100 miles north of Phoenix, right at the southern end of the famous Oak Creek Canyon.
Magnificent Sedona. That's what many of the people who live around here call this charming little town that up until recently has been one of Arizona's best-kept vacation secrets. But that was up until recently. These days, Sedona is becoming pretty famous.
And no wonder. It's neither desert nor mountains. It's got the perfect climate, it's got great scenery, and the people are very friendly.
So naturally, what was once just a post office on the side of the road has turned into, well, quite a unique little town. And in the next half hour, we'll show you why.
Sedona is the kind of place where people come for a visit and stay.
That's right. It's beautiful red rock scenery, its climate, and the people make all the difference and make this different than any other place in the world.
And in the next half hour, we're going to show you why. We're about to take a time expedition into the mountains and learn the mystery and lore of Sedona with Warren Kramer.
We'll also get photographic tips on how to make your vacation photos really something special as we photograph Sedona with Bob and Suzanne Clements.
And we'll meet some artists who use this beautiful land as their inspiration to their lives.
There'll be all that and a whole lot more coming up on Side by Side, so stay right there.
Oh, we ain't got a barrel of money, but baby, the skies will be sunny if we travel along, singing a song side by side.
All right, Linda, say cheese.
I'm ready.
All right.
Boy, that'll be a good one.
I hope so. Right. Welcome back on Side by Side. Chris and Linda Lewis exploring the wonders of Sedona, Arizona.
And you know, how many times have you been like us and those folks over there? You've gone out on vacation, taken your camera with you, taken hundreds of photographs, and then you've been disappointed when you've gotten them back from the lab.
Somehow they never seem to look as great as you thought they would.
That's true.
But right now, we are going to meet two photographers who can tell you how to improve your snapshot style.
Exactly. First, I'm going to introduce you to Mr. Bob Clements. He's an award-winning photographer who's taken pictures for magazines like Arizona Highways, and he's going to show us how the pros take photos.
Then I'm going to talk to Suzanne Clements about how you can get a great vacation photograph.
And that's what a professional photographer sees when he's focusing on a wonderful scene like this. And Bob Clements' photographs have been on everything from magazine covers to jigsaw puzzles to calendars. And Bob, welcome to Side by Side.
Thank you.
To a skier, there is nothing more invigorating, nothing more challenging than descending some 2,000 feet over a washboard mountain slope into the valley below.
To those who don't ski, there is nothing more beautiful, more inspiring than those who do.
And perhaps nowhere in America do they both come together in a more beautiful setting than here, in America's first and still one of the country's most popular ski resorts, Sun Valley, Idaho.
Hi, and welcome to Side by Side. I'm Linda Lewis.
And I'm Christopher Lewis. And whether you're a skier or not, I know you're going to like this next half hour because we're going to give you a look at a very special part of America.
A little ski village nestled in the Sawtooth Mountains of Idaho that brings together artists, celebrities, sportsmen, just plain visitors like us, to a magical setting fit for a Hollywood romance movie.
And what could be more fitting for a Hollywood romance movie than to start the program out with a wonderful sleigh ride in a brand new sleigh?
Oh, isn't it gorgeous? Just look at this.
Hello, Chris and Linda.
Hi, Jerry.
Hi. Here. Let's go for a ride.
All right. Great. Sounds good to me.
And what's the horse's name?
Bingo.
Bingo.
Oh, she's up and ready to go. Great experience.
Oh, isn't this wonderful sleigh ride?
Yeah.
You know, earlier you were talking about Hollywood movies, romance movies, and how this is kind of tied in with that.
Uh-huh.
Well, you know, that's why Sun Valley is here, really, because back in the early 1940s, Sonia Heaney, John Payne, and the Glenn Miller Orchestra really starred in a movie about Sun Valley called Sun Valley Serenade.
Is that right?
Yeah, that started it all off.
Makes sense.
Once the movie hit the silver screen, this place was on the map. Pretty soon, the stars themselves started coming here to get away from the pressures of Tinseltown. And that's a custom that continues even today, as we'll show you before the half hour's up. The first time I saw this storybook valley was about 40 years ago, when my family came here from Hollywood for our Christmas vacation. It was a wonderful, magical time for us then. I was about 5 years old. My brother Peter was four, and I can distinctly remember arriving by train back then. You see, that was the only way you could get here in the early days.
Oh, dear.
Well, it's been about 40 years since that wonderful vacation, so we decided that it was about time to come back here to Sun Valley because I wanted to share with Linda some of my childhood memories here. And it would also give us a chance to explore one of America's most popular vacation ideas, see what's remained the same here over the past 40 years and what's changed.
And we are going to rediscover the legend of Sun Valley in the next half hour.
So stay with us on Side by Side. Adam West, TV's Batman, and his wife Marcel moved here in 1986, and they've been raising a family here ever since, and they say it sure beats Hollywood as a place to live.
You recognize me?
Yeah. Yeah. Who could help?
Well, we're just hanging out in the street corner here in Ketchum, Marcel and I. We moved up here because we felt it was a wonderful place to bring our kids up. It's just a town that seems to have what most resort towns have, and on the other hand, it has a great sort of family life quality to it as well.
Well, you guys are really part of the community. I mean, you are involved in everything from to PTA to the Wagon Days.
Yeah, that's the Ore Wagon Museum there.
Oh, right there.
Isn't this a coincidence?
Right, happen to be talking about it, folks.
Our timing's perfect.
Yeah, anyway, see, Ketchum used to be a silver mining town at one time, silver. And as a matter of fact, it was the largest sheep shipping center in the country at one time.
Right?
Now, say that three or four times
I knew you said
fast.
That very carefully.
Sheep shipping center, sheep shipping center, sheep.
Well, everywhere you look in this town, there's a great view, you know? And I bet you have good restaurants here, too.
Yeah, we've got a lot of restaurants, and, you know, they really vary from, like, the Western Cafe to places you go in. You spend a lot of bucks. We eat at home.
Right. Well, you're a working stiff.
Sure,
you know?
That's right.
Working stiffs,
eat at home.
Mm.
Yeah,
but it really is something about us being a ski resort. But it isn't really just a ski resort, is it? I mean,
No. It's
really a year-round resort.
It is a year-round resort.
What are the summers like here?
By golly, I found
They're
a dime.
They're my favorite.
Hold on.
He is a working stiff.
Found a dime. He is a working stiff.
He's going to stop and
Not
pick
a plant.
A
we found a dime.
Everyone, I'll buy you a beer.
So this is one of your favorite hangouts, huh?
Louis, huh?
Well, it's a good family place, you know, and yeah.
Thursday parties.
What, do you want to have something to eat?
Yeah, let's go on in, and we want to thank you really very much for being on the show. It's been a pleasure.
Hey, no problem, as long as you pick up the check.
Okay, do it. We'll do it. No problem.
And there's more fun coming up on the show, because when we come back, we're going to the Duchin Cup Celebrity Ski Race,
where we'll watch your favorite celebrities go head-to-head down Mount Baldy.
All that and more coming up on Side by Side, so you stay right there. Well, that's it. Our quick look at one of the most popular natural vacation ideas here in the Northwest, Portland, Oregon.
And you know, Linda, one of the fine things about vacationing here in Portland, aside from the weather and the beautiful people and the scenery, is of course there is no state sales tax here in Oregon, so when you buy souvenirs or food, it's a little cheaper here in the state.
Makes it better for all of us
it
who
certainly
like to
does.
Shop.
And if you'd like to learn more about vacationing here in the City of Roses, we have an address you can write to and a phone number you can call. Write to the Portland, Oregon Visitors Association at 26 Southwest Salmon, Box T as in Tom, Portland, Oregon, and the zip is 97204. Or you can call them at area code 503-222-2223. And we're going to leave you now in front of Portland's famous and beautiful train station with some more impressions of Portland, the Mount Hood area, and the magnificent Columbia River Gorge.
Which should be a reminder to us all of the beauty of nature and our responsibility to keep it that way.
We'll see you next time we go traveling side by side.
Bye-bye.
So long now.